Stephen A., I want to start with you on this one. Talk to me. What's your reaction to what McNair said and what went down?
Well, it was highly insensitive, inappropriate. You could say he made a mistake because the phrase is inmates running the asylum. He said inmates running the prison. But nevertheless, it was something that was echoed during an owner's meeting. When you consider the minds that are in that room, the kind of conversation that they were planning on tackling, that just heightens the level of ignorance that he displayed. Because if you're sitting there, and not that at any time it's an excuse, but if you're sitting there having a drink, hanging out with your buddies, and you articulate something, that's entirely different than you meeting in a league office with players to discuss issues that Colin Kaepernick brought to the forefront of most of our minds in the United States of America because of his willingness to take the stance that he took. And so if you're Mr. McNair and you take this position, it just heightens the level of insensitivity that's going to get attached to you. I saw this in my initial reaction, and it's something I'll elaborate more extensively on with my final take today. But my initial reaction is that be appalled, be upset, be disgusted with this man, but remember, you still got a job to do. You got Bill O'Brien who didn't make those comments. You've got 60 to 80,000 people showing up at the stadium who didn't make those comments. You have a general manager who's an African American and Rick Smith that obviously is your boss as well. And you got to be accountable to him as well. And so I was proud that DeAndre Hopkins ultimately elected to show up and show out the way that he did, because my God, did he show out yesterday afternoon. But in the end, what it comes down to is that if you're the NFL players and you're the Players Association, this is further evidence of the divide that exists between the mindset of owners and that of players. And somehow, some way, you've got to find constructive measures to address these matters so owners like this don't think about saying such things, and more importantly, they don't conduct themselves action-wise in doing things that would indicate that this is truly how they feel about the players. I think it's you can call it a teachable moment all you want to, Max Donovan, but to me, it's a highlighting moment. It's an illuminating moment because, you know how the man feels, which is why if I took anything away from it, it was what Richard Sherman had to say. Why are we tripping? The man exposed and revealed what he thinks and how he truly feels. And that's really what this comes down to. And sometimes that's not a cause for disgust. It's a cause for celebration, because now we know. And now you can go forward from there.
As cynical as I may be, in terms of my gut reaction as just a person when I hear something like this, you know, inmates running the prison. Well, actually, the term is asylum. So it's not a nut house to you. It's like a prison. Like, and we're getting all Freudian and everything and OK, so the players aren't business partners. As I mentioned, Adam Silver comes out after the controversy with Donald Sterling. He made racist remarks, was caught making them. And I was expecting a fine or something, business as usual. And Adam Silver said, you have deeply, profoundly affected our business partners. Get out. Right. Well, that's one way of viewing the players. And another way is as prisoners to your status quo. So I understand the gut reaction, even though I also understand someone saying, look, it was a figure of speech that he misused. Everyone's being very sensitive. So let me just say, like with Kaepernick in the beginning, Stephen A., I didn't come out and say Kaepernick is being treated unfairly, X, Y, and Z. My initial comment was Kaepernick, I think, is looking for a starter's position. And he does a starting job, and maybe people feel he's just bubble starter. Maybe he's not good enough quite. But a backup job, when he never got even the backup job, then it was time to come out and say, okay, he's being treated unfairly, and here's why I believe he's being treated that way. Now, in this situation, McNair has come out, and since he made these comments, said it was an unfortunate turn of a phrase, and he really apologized for anyone he offended. And anyway, and here's the key, he claims, I wasn't referring to the players. I was referring to the league office, because after all, Goodell and the league office, they work for the owners. Those are the inmates to whom he was referring, according to McNair. I'll take him at his word right now, cynical though I may be, that that's in fact what he was saying. Let's take him at his word. Do you realize the implications of that, Stephen A. and Donovan? If he actually meant that, then the question is he in some way calling for Goodell's firing? Is he saying they need to rein in the commissioner? And the reason that would be an even bigger deal, in my view, than, You know, listen, have we seen white people in positions of power in sports ownership make racist comments in the past? Yeah, that in fact is nothing new. It's terrible, it's always bad, we understand, but we also know it's not new. What would be new is a sitting commissioner getting the ouster. I mean, these guys retire, all of them. They never get fired. What commissioner in a major sport, NBA, MLB, NFL, gets canned by the owners, essentially, which is what it would be if they don't renew Goodell's contract. So if McNair, in fact, didn't mean the players, if he meant the players, it'd be a big deal. Maybe it's an even bigger deal if he's talking about Goodell.